Digestion is the process by which the complex organic substances are turned into simpler products to be absorbed to the human body. The entire digestion process is supported by mechanical digestion as well as chemical digestion. During the mechanical digestion, the food is broken into small pieces, and during the chemical digestion, the food is turned into simpler substances due to the action of enzymes on food. We are eating different types of food rich with various nutrients. The nutrients like some vitamins, minerals, salts, and simple sugars are absorbed to the blood without any digestion. But most of the nutrients get absorbed after the digestion. The organs involved in food digestion are collectively called as digestive system. It is a single tube, commences from the mouth and ends up at the anus. It is also known as alimentary canal. The component organs of the digestive system are mouth cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and anus. Salivary glands and pancreas are glands associated with the digestive system. And also the liver and the gallbladder are supportive organs for the process of digestion. The functions of the digestive system are food digestion, absorption of nutrients, removal of undigested materials or elimination. The digestive system commences from the buccal cavity. Mouth opens the buccal cavity to the environment. The buccal cavity is made up from upper jaw and lower jaw. Only the lower jaw is movable. Teeth, mouth, and salivary glands are the structures found in buccal cavity that helps in digestion. Salivary glands secrete saliva. Tongue helps in identification of taste and mixing food with saliva. The enzyme ptyalene or salivary amylase is secreted on food by salivary glands. It acts on starch and turns starch into maltose. Maltose is sweet. That's why a sweet taste is sensed when chewing rice or bread for some time. So, it is very clear that both chemical and mechanical digestion begins at buccal cavity. The initially digested food mixed with saliva and forms a bolus and pushed towards the pharynx. Pharynx is a common area to both digestive and respiratory tracts. Epiglottis helps to prevent entering food into trachea. As it is shown in the second diagram, trachea is blocked by epiglottis when food is passing. Then the food enters the esophagus. Food passes in esophagus by peristalsis. As esophagus is a muscular structure, due to contractions and relaxations of its wall, the peristaltic movements appear as waves. Then the food is moved into stomach by peristaltic movements. Stomach is a dilated sac-like organ. Due to the peristaltic activity of muscles in the stomach, the bolus is further subjected to mechanical digestion and broken into small pieces. And then mixed well with the secretions oozed out by the stomach wall and turned into chyme. Gastric juice is composed with hydrochloric acid, enzymes, pepsin and renin. HCl activates pepsin and also kills some bacteria. The enzyme pepsin breaks proteins into polypeptides, so the digestion of proteins begins in the stomach. Renin present in infants causes coagulation of milk. Food remains in the stomach for 4 to 5 hours. The chyme containing partially digested lipids, water, minerals and vitamins are now released to the C-shaped area or the duodenum of the small intestine. The entire small intestine is 6 to 7 meters in length. The pancreatic duct from the pancreas and the bile duct from the gallbladder opens into the duodenum via single pore. Bile produced in the liver, stored in gallbladder and released to the duodenum through the bile duct. Bile contains bile pigments, bile salts, bicarbonate, ions and water. Bile stands to emulsify or break down lipids in food into small droplets. So, enzymes get a greater surface area to act on lipids on food. The intestinal juice is secreted by the wall of the intestine. It contains maltase, sucrase, peptidase and mucus. The enzyme trypsin converts proteins into polypeptides. The enzyme amylase converts starch into maltose. And the enzyme lipase converts lipids into fatty acids and glycerol. Then the chyme passes along the rest of the small intestine. The small intestine is especially adapted to increase the efficiency of absorption of food. These are the adaptations shown by the small intestine. Being a long tube. Presence of circular folds in the inner wall. Presence of finger-like projections called villi or villi in the circular folds. Presence of microvilli in the epithelial cells of villi. Thin epithelial lining on villi are highly vascularized by blood capillaries. Once the food passes along the small intestine, the food is mixed with intestinal juice, contains the enzymes maltase, sucrase, lactase and peptidase. The enzyme maltase converts maltose into glucose. The enzyme sucrase converts sucrose into glucose and fructose. The enzyme lactase converts lactose into glucose and galactose. The enzyme peptidase converts polypeptides into amino acids. These end products of digestion get absorbed into highly vascularized villi. Fatty acids and fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E, K are absorbed into lacteal. Vitamin BC, monosaccharides, amino acids and mineral salts get absorbed to the blood capillaries. Once the end products of digestion got absorbed, the undigested food enters the large intestine. It is a tubular structure in a length of 1.5 meters which begins at cecum and ends up at anus. Water present in the undigested food entered the large intestine and rest is turned into semi-solid fecal matter. The fecal matter is stored in rectum and released through the anus when necessary.